Arizona State University is leading a new national research center that looks to revolutionize the energy industry. The center is a collaboration of universities, energy companies, and entrepreneurs committed to solving the challenges of harnessing solar power in economically viable and sustainable ways. Quantum Energy and Sustainable Solar Technology, or QESST, will be directed by Christina Honsberg, a professor in ASU's School of Electrical, Computer, and Energy Engineering. I recently talked with Honsberg about the project. And thank you so much for joining us on
Horizon.
Thank you for having me. What is the goal of this project?
QESST is a new engineering research center that's funded by NSF and the Department of Energy. And the goal of it is to advance photovoltaics, or solar energy. So you'll see solar energy on calculators or on other sort of consumer electronics. And what we want to do is make it not just power calculators, but make it power houses, businesses, make it essentially power the U.S.
Basically make it economically viable.
That's correct.
And how do you do that?
There are two-pronged approach that we use. The first is that you have to get the performance up. So the measure of performance for solar cells is called efficiency. Mm-hmm. And if you make the same block of material produce more power, then you're paying for the material, but you get more energy out of it, so the costs go down. So one of the key focuses we have is to get a double win. You produce more power and lower the cost at the same time.
And that, I guess that would slide into also the idea of manufacturing as well, correct?
That's right. Mm-hmm. There's about 50 companies who are involved with us and about 7 other universities on the project. And actually the company involvement at the early on is actually quite unique. So rather than just having a technology that goes into the lab and then after 3 years we talk to industry and see if they're interested, industry is involved with us right from the beginning.
Industry involved right from the beginning. Talk more about that public-private partnership and how important that is.
So the industry is growing very, very rapidly. It's been growing at 40% a year for nearly 2 decades. And so this gives a very strong opportunity for universities to get their new technologies out to industry. But the pace of the industry is such that if you've been developing a technology for 3 years, they've grown 40% for 3 years. They're already beyond what you may have done. So having a partnership between the two of them is absolutely essential to get the technology to develop rapidly.
Now the goal, a majority of new electricity in 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And the idea, what could be 1.5 billion people being affected by this, another goal?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So presently 1.5 billion people don't have access to electricity. So our goal is to make solar cells a little bit like the cell phones. So the people who don't have electricity also generally don't have a landline. But they've actually just completely bypassed landlines and are now using cell phones. So for the developing world, rather than putting in the utility grid the way we have here, the goal would be to just go right to solar or right to technologies that are distributed.
And again, in terms of economic viability, does that make sense?
Yes, mm-hmm, absolutely. So right now it makes sense already in a lot of markets. So the cost of it is actually dependent on where you put it in. The more sun you have, the more electricity you have. So it makes more sense to put it into sunnier locations. So in sunny locations with relatively high electricity costs, it already makes viable sense. So there are markets like that in the U.S. Also, it always makes economic sense for what's called peaking power. So peaking power is where the utility company charges you more for your power near solar noon or near the middle of the day. Mm-hmm. So it's economic for that as well.
Without getting too much into particles turning into waves and waves turning into particles, I know the quantum mechanics is a part of this particular project. How?
Well, actually, this is a very interesting part. Maybe a succinct way of saying what we want to do is that we want to bring the semiconductor revolution to energy. So quantum mechanics is the basis of computers, of all your cell phones, is the basis of the information technology revolution. And photovoltaics is actually a very unique energy source. Every other type of energy source has rotating machinery, but not photovoltaics. It's based on semiconductors and quantum mechanics. You just shine light on it and it generates electricity. So this has a couple implications. One is no moving parts. We don't use any water. We don't emit any pollutants. So it's a very clean, very long-lasting, very distributed technology. I think another implication of it is that the semiconductor industry has just grown enormously and has impacted everybody's lives. And we think that the photovoltaic industry can grow as enormously, and in 10 years, just the same way you see a computer everywhere, a cell phone everywhere, you'll just see photovoltaics on everybody's house.
It's like 10 years ago, smartphones weren't so smart.
That's right.
10 years from now, photovoltaic will be a lot smarter than it
That's
is
right.
now.
Mm-hmm.
How did ASU get involved in all this?
ASU is a leader in solar energy, particularly in photovoltaics. We have a large set of experimental facilities for it, so it was pretty natural that ASU went and led the engineering research center. And of course, we're also very dependent on our partners. So our partners in this are California Institute of Technology, MIT, University of Delaware, Georgia Tech. So we've got a bunch of partners. And of course, University of Arizona is one of our partners, too.
And the government is interested, obviously, as well, when
That's
you
right.
mentioned DOE and NSF. Why is that? Is this considered vital national interest here?
Yes, I think it's of enormous national interest. Part of it is just pure economic interest. This is going to be a trillion-dollar industry. Right now, Germany and Japan hold the lead in it. But the U.S. is certainly going to be the next big market, and it's absolutely essential that the U.S. grab as much of that trillion-dollar market as it can. It's a clean technology, so you can make money, make jobs, and help the environment all at once.
And you mentioned the University of Delaware among those participating.
Right.
We were talking beforehand. Delaware is a leader in solar technology.
That's
isn't
right.
It? Mm-hmm. How did that happen?
They've long had a strong focus on making chemicals, and a lot of the semiconductors is actually quite closely related to the chemical industry.
Okay.
So I think it's another example of how strength in one industry, you can use it to piggyback and to get a leg up on a new industry.
Because when Arizonans see a Delaware leading the pack, you kind of wonder what's going on here in Arizona.
Last
question, what is going on here in Arizona?
We have a very rapidly growing program. We've got a lot of courses on it. So ASU is very heavily involved in it. University of Arizona is heavily involved. And not only the university, but of course First Solar is the largest U.S. producer. And so their headquarters are very close to here. They recently just installed a new PV plant here. There's actually several companies that are here. Suntech is another very large manufacturer. They're in the Phoenix area with a production plant. Soytech is another concentrating manufacturer. They have their major research labs here. In addition to them, there's a lot of sales offices here. So Arizona has the sunlight. It's a very high-tech city, which is needed for solar. So it's a natural place to have it.
And it sounds like a project like this can be a good educational tool as well
Absolutely.
For some ASU
mm-hmm.
students. All right, very good.
Okay.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.